History has it that coffee may have originated from Ethiopia, but according to statistics, the country that consumes coffee the most is Finland. A young Nigerian man has, however, found another interesting use for the beverage besides just drinking.
My name is Ekene Ngige. I'm from Anambra State. I'm a visual artist based in Lagos. I'm a graduate of fine arts from Yaba College of Technology. I was branding coffee in Victoria Island. I was having a meeting with them and I was having this cappuccino. And it spilled on my paper, you know. And when it spilled on my paper, I liked the splash it gave on the paper. When I saw it, I just decided to allow it dry up, and it inspired me to like go home and see if I could use it to paint. And when I did that, it turned out very nice, you know. Then I didn't know that there were already artists in Europe, Asia, that actually did paint with coffee. I thought it was something I discovered for myself, and all that too. With time, I expanded my skill from painting with coffee on paper to painting with coffee on canvas. So when I did my research, I found out a lot of artists do paint on paper. Few of them do paint on canvas, very few. And in fact, they used to holler at me on Instagram to tell them how I actually do paint on canvas to preserve it to stay. I got the roasted beans from Umutu. Umutu actually rare coffee here in Nigeria. They're rare in Delta State. So it even makes me happier to know that everything I'm using to work is made here in Africa, made here in Nigeria. The only challenge I've had concerning coffee painting is that I could only use the instant coffee to paint. And using the instant coffee means I have to actually stick to one brand or two. I've had buyers come all the way from England and Monaco just to come and pick up artwork from me from coffee. On the internet, I get a lot of people, foreigners especially, wanting to know how it's done, wanting to know how much or how affordable the artworks are and all that. So it's been nice.
Nigeria has gone 3 years without a case of polio, putting it on the brink of being declared free from the disease. But Ekene has had to struggle with polio for the greater part of his life. How has this affected his work so far?
I work and live my daily life like it's normal. You know, like every other normal person is working and living theirs. My art department was in a four-story building. Top floor. And my lecturers used to be like, are you sure you don't want to have your special classes on the ground floor? And we'll be teaching you there and all that. And I was like, it doesn't make sense to me. I'm here to expand my skills. So if you still isolate me to my own kingdom, I'll be feeling like I'm good enough when I'm not having challenge, I'm not competing with others in their classes and all that. So I want to be in their midst and compete with the best. I don't have anything in mind than to expand this coffee painting. I want people to learn about it. I want people to explore it. I want schools to explore it, you know, and add it to their curriculums and all that. It's the same challenges we face in the digital arts, because right now we have the universities that teach fine art and visual art, but none of them teach digital graphics or animations and all that kind of stuff. So that is how far I want this to go.